Cosmic's first Alpha launched on August 6th, but Alpha 1 is not the end, and Alpha 2 has just arrived. Now, as with last time and every other time I'm going to talk about this, it is an alpha, and alpha software has alpha problems. It still has a ton of bugs. Many of them won't be new. For example, screenshots are still completely broken on vertical monitors. There are still going to be a ton of missing features. However, I can confidently say the state of Cosmic now is better than it was a month and a half ago. And in a month and a half from now, it's going to be even better. Now, I can't talk about every single change that was made. If you want to see that, go to the Git history, start scrolling, and then you'll see it. But I was sent a 10-page document by System76 outlining some of the things that at least they think are big changes since Alpha 1. Now, if you've seen my Cosmic streams, a lot of what I'm going to talk about here probably isn't new, because it is open source software, so whilst it is Alpha 2, it's just a tagged Git commit, you can see everything being done completely publicly. Now, I don't know why it didn't get more of a focus, but on page 9 of the press release I was sent, it had the most important change being mentioned. When I talked about Alpha 1, theming did not work in Cosmic. It was completely busted. All of the settings was there, and you could change them, but they didn't work. At least on a mechanical hard drive, because what it would do is every time you tried something like changing background opacity, it would lock up the entire desktop, and in some cases, lock it up for multiple minutes. Now, it's still not perfect. As you can see here, it does tend to freeze a little bit, and the reason for that is because it is making live changes. It's not waiting till you're done and then applying everything, it's applying them as you do things. This is very evident with things like the active window hint size. If we click this a bunch, it is going to delay updating things here, but it is getting set. This especially is one of the ones that would cause multiple minute lockups. Now, you might have said, just don't buy a mechanical hard drive, and yes, that would make the theming work, but your drive was still getting completely saturated. It was completely nuking your drive for absolutely no reason, so I'm very, very happy this has been fixed. Now, another big change is the existence of these sound settings. Now, there was an applet during Alpha 1, so you could do most of what you wanted here, and that would be fine. But now it exists in the system settings as well. So we have both our output and our input here. We can go and change what device we want to use. I'm not going to do so because it might cause a problem with the recording. There is a slight issue here. The little marker here that indicates 100%. For some reason, the handle is off-center. I have reported this. I don't know why it is like this. It could be a stylistic choice, but I don't think so. Also, if you're someone who uses a Bluetooth audio device, that is going to be here as well. And we also have network settings, which I don't know what the deal with the ordering here is. I assume this is going to change because network settings is right at the top. This should probably be alphabetical order. I'm assuming they've just like manually placed it right there. And like with the sound, yes, there was an applet before. This would do pretty much all you want it to do. I don't know why Wi-Fi is on. I don't actually have Wi-Fi in this system. That shouldn't even be able to turn on. That's probably a bug as well. Because I only have the wired connection, we can go and click on this. We can go and disconnect this. If you have multiple Ethernet ports, it is going to be listed in here as well. Now, under the three dots here, there is a settings thing. In my case, this is going to open up Network Manager. I don't know if they're going to make their own custom thing for this or just rely on an application like this. I would imagine probably in the long run they will make something, because opening this just feels really out of place with the rest of the desktop being libcosmic. Also, if you're a VPN enjoyer, you can manage your VPN connections here, and this is a perfect time to have a VPN sponsor. I do not have one, so I don't know. Pick a VPN you like, use Molvad or something, I don't know. Also, if you do have Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi settings are going to be here as well. And another new thing is the power and battery settings. I am not a laptop user. This is a desktop system. My keyboard here is wired. It technically can be wireless, but I'm using it plugged in. But if you have a laptop, if you're using Bluetooth devices, other wireless devices, all of that power stuff is going to be listed here, the current battery levels. Also, there's going to be the option of pre-configured power modes. Now, if there's one thing I'm very particular about, it's the way that window management feels. At the start of Alpha 1, there was a major problem I had. The way Cosmic is configured out of the box, I have a problem with, but at least I can configure it. And during Alpha 2, it is better, but I still have some issues. So you might have noticed, I don't know if I showed it actually, as I move my mouse between the windows, focus changes on hover. If we go to our desktop settings, go to the window management, now we have the option of focus follows cursor, focus follows cursor delay in milliseconds, and cursor follows focus. So I'm going to turn this off and this off. So this is the way that Cosmic works out of the box. To change window focus, you have to click on a window. I don't like this. I know this is the way that Windows does things, and I know that GNOME users do this out of the box as well. I just don't like it. Window managers always do focus follows cursor. So when you hover over a window, that window is given focus. Now, by default, this is set to 250 milliseconds. This means there's going to be a 250 millisecond delay before the focus is changed. Let's change this up to 1000 to make that more clear. There we go. And back again. There we go. I would recommend keeping this either low or at zero. Now, cursor follows focus is a little bit different. If you open up a window or you use the keybinds to change window focus, it's going to make the cursor go to the window you're focused on. So if I go over to this one on the left, it's there. Go to the one on the right, it's there. Now, a lot of window managers put the cursor in the middle of the window to avoid exactly the problem you just saw. So let's go back here and then go here. If I move slightly left or slightly up, this window is given focus. So if it's in the middle, that problem can't happen. Now the other issue I have is most evident at 0 milliseconds. Let's open a bunch of windows and move to here, move to here, move. Window focus is just like constantly snapping around. Now that's obviously what you want if you're on 0 milliseconds, but the way that KDE addresses this is having window focus and window raising be separate. So I could go and put my focus on this window on the left here, but it doesn't raise any windows in the process until I click on the window. This is my preferred method of doing things. I've reported it a while back. Hopefully it gets implemented. And while we're here, if you're not a fan of having the super key open up your launcher or your super key open up workspaces or applications, you can just disable the functionality altogether. If we set that, no matter how much we press the super key, nothing is going to happen. I would like the option to move this to another button. So maybe instead of having this under window management, put this under the shortcut section and have a modifier only shortcut feature. Now, here is my opinion when it comes to window scaling. Don't. Buy a different monitor. Buy a bigger monitor. Buy a laptop with a sensible resolution. If you need to do so, though, even during Alpha 1, there was scaling there. But now, we have X11 window system application scaling. So the option of scale all X11 applications. I cannot zoom in on this because Zoom is not a feature yet. X11 applications will appear blurry on high DPI screens, or render X11 applications at native resolution. X11 applications that don't support scaling will be small when high DPI displays are in use, enable for games to utilize the full monitor resolution. So try out both these settings, see what makes sense for what you're trying to do, or just buy a sensible monitor. Now, I don't care what anyone has to say. This is the file manager I typically use. This is PCManFM GTK3. I like it. I'm happy with it. Get over it. But Cosmic Files is slowly turning into a file manager you actually might want to use. We have features like a search bar, a recents tab. We have compression right here and also extraction. Why is the... Okay, there's issues with pressing escape key to close the context menu. I'll report that. We have network drives. I do not have one, so there is nothing here. We have a file menu that's basically complete that has bindings for pretty much everything you want here. When this is used as a file picker, it'll now default into floating mode, even if you have a tiling layout, which is the thing it should be doing. Also, okay, the escape key is really wonky with closing this. I will definitely report that. If you click on a file, it will now open a preview on the right-hand side. We now have interface density settings. So we have comfortable, compact, and spacious. I would like it to be a slider, so it's something you can configure to exactly what you want. But this is comfortable, this is compact, and this is spacious. Now you might notice a slight issue. Comfortable, compact, spacious. The ordering is incorrect. It goes middle, smallest, largest. You also might notice it's alphabetical ordering, but yeah, it's clearly wrong. But the settings work. And here's a bunch of random rapid fire things. Custom shortcuts, I didn't realize this was a problem, can now be searched for in your shortcut settings. If you use your system in a non-English language, the Cosmic Greeter will now respect that and show you the written date in your respective language. Whilst it does say it is open, the problem has been fixed and meta key resizing, so meta and right click, now actually works. Previously, if the application had a context menu, when you did this, it would open up the context menu and the resizing would break. If you have a laptop, it is now no longer going to show the battery with a decimal value, which wasn't being reported anyway, so it's a useless decimal. Cosmic Screenshot can now no longer kill the entire desktop. Previously, you could open up the screenshot tool, make a selection capture, and if you don't select anything, you would have a garbled screenshot. If you try to open that in something like GIMP, the entire desktop would die. Cosmic apps now launch in the ISO they provide if you're using an NVIDIA GPU. For a lot of people, they were just not opening, which kind of made the ISO they provided entirely useless for NVIDIA users. Again, for a full list of changes, just head over to any of the repos, start scrolling through the merge request, start scrolling through the issues and the git commits, and you'll find everything being done. I'm recording this before the alpha actually comes out, but I imagine they're probably going to release some sort of like blog post or notes that also explain everything. If that exists, I will link it in the description down below. One really big change unrelated to the features directly is the way the release model's being done. So between Alpha 1 and 2, there was like a month and a half-ish gap. Like, not exactly a month and a half. It's a very weird gap, doesn't make much sense, hard to plan around. Going forward, there's going to be a one-month gap between each Alpha. So if things go as planned, October 26th, we're going to have the next alpha, November 26th, so on and so forth, until it's not in an alpha state anymore, and they're ready to move it into a beta. In beta, we don't know exactly what the model's going to be, but I assume it's going to move a little bit slower. Also, by having these one-month gaps, it makes it a lot easier if you don't want to run each individual git commit to only update to each alpha and not be super lagged behind. As with Alpha 1, there is an Alpha 2 ISO available as well, but if you want to run things directly on whatever distro you happen to be on, I'm on Arch Linux, there is going to be a tagged release on Arch. If you want to use the Git version and you don't want to compile it, there are packages available on the Chaotic AUR, on Fedora, on other things like that. There are instructions on what you can do there as well. Or it's a project, it's open source, you can compile it yourself, if you have lots and lots of time and want to compile a desktop environment written in Rust. For any of the enjoyers of the last Cosmic Breaking stream, I will be doing another one sometime soon. I don't know if I'm going to do it this weekend just because of like how close it is to the last one I did, and next weekend I'm busy, so it might be like halfway between this alpha and the next alpha, but I'll see what I do. Regardless, there will be another Cosmic Cracking stream. It was very fun. A lot of the bugs I reported last time have been addressed. Others have been discussed. So it seems like it's helping. But let me know your thoughts on Cosmic down below. Have you tried it out so far? If you want to try it out and you haven't done so yet, what is holding you back? Like, what do you want to have added before it's ready for you? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of... I forgot we don't have the thing. These amazing people over here, check out Patreon, Scribes, Liberate, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And if I'm focused on the OBS window, I can use my hotkeys, but that's annoying. I really, really would like the option to use my hotkeys globally, like KDE has a solution for. That would be nice.